It's going to be a tough act to follow for sure. I'm not sure how many new piece of advice I could offer. That was a great, great talk. I'm happy to report, when I moved to Canada, we were very well prepared to brave the elements. We had parkas, toques, gloves, woolen socks, hats, you name it, the whole nine yards. It was June when we moved. We got a lot of funny looks at the airport, in the plane, as we were wearing our toques, our jackets, our parkas, the whole nine yards. It was June. Everybody told us how cold Canada was. It was June. We were boiling. So there is such a thing as being overprepared. And of course, when you make such a big move, you've maxed out all of your luggage allowances, so you have no place to put your toques and parkas and all of those other things. So yeah, it was a rather long 24-hour flight from India. So that brings me to how I moved to Canada. I did my high school in India, and similar to your story, my parents have a business background. My dad is an accountant, and at that time, the Canadian government was advertising for accountants. It was more or less the same ad that people have seen in different magazines. We want you for accounting. Mm-hmm. It's a different ad, but you get the point. So there were ads being floated around for accounting positions open in Canada, and believe it or not, there were people interviewing for accountants in India. The British accounting system is very similar, if not identical, to what we have here. So there was very, very limited learning curves there. So because there were good opportunities from an economic standpoint, the family was offered a very fast-tracked immigration to Canada. So the question, why did you come to Canada? I had no choice. The family was moving. So it was basically move with us or good luck. So that's why we picked Canada. Now, having said that, I should qualify that. Before actually moving, we had already traveled to the U.S. and Canada a couple of times. So we were somewhat familiar with Niagara Falls and CN Tower and so on. We did, during the travels to both the States and Canada, we had decided that the States was not for us. There was a much much better fit with Canada than the U.S., just based on our own personal preferences, quality of life, things of that nature. So when the offer came to come to Canada, based on the accounting opportunities, so we picked a moving date in June, like I mentioned earlier. And away we went. Why did we come to London, Ontario? That was a good question. Couple of things. I had applied for universities, and I wasn't so familiar with the whole online registration system. Well, it wasn't online at that time, but anyway. I applied by mistake to Western. More specifically to King's College at Western. There were two King's Colleges at that time. I did not know that. I tell this to King's people all the time. I applied by mistake to King's College, and by mistake I also accepted the admission to King's College. So when I arrived first day at King's, I was looking for the big tower with the clock. Well, that's at Western, not at King's. I found that out the next week. Things kept rolling. Actually, I was very, very happy to be a part of King's, and I'll get into that in a moment. I chose a business to start with, following the family's footsteps. Of course, those are generally the starting point for a 16, 17-year-old kid who really doesn't know what to do in life. Which, by the way, I don't know why people ask those questions. At that age, nobody should know what they want to do in life. You really should find that out once you've put some years in education and whatnot. So I made some good contacts early on at King's through the registrar's office. They had an incredible support system to help with newcomers to Canada. And in all seriousness, there were a number of challenges. I remember, again, at that age, it's difficult to leave all your friends, and everything that you know about a culture has essentially completely changed. And there were a lot of early learning curves. I tend to mix my V's and W's, so the V's come out as W's and the other way around. So try going to Pizza Hut and order a wedgie pizza. Doesn't quite work that well. And I still hear that all the time, and I often have to intervene to clarify that what it actually means before, you know, something unfortunate happens. So simple things like that were interesting challenges to overcome. Communication was obviously a key issue. While I learned English right from kindergarten, but you know, the slangs are different, and I didn't understand half of the things that were being spoken to me. What's interesting, and I still pick this up doing grocery shopping and different things like that, I hear other people speak, and I was equally guilty early on. I used to mix my native language and English halfway through. So I would start the conversation in English, and halfway through, the person who's hearing me wouldn't understand a word that's coming out of my mouth because I've switched from English into a different language halfway through. And of course, you don't know when you're talking. And I still hear this from time to time. So those were some of the interesting early on challenges and barriers. But coming back to how those barriers were overcome, the King's College setup that I mentioned earlier was incredibly impressive. Really, I missed the King's days. I was offered my first job by King's as well. My first job was as a tour guide. I'd never given a tour to anybody. I didn't know where the residences were. I didn't know where the washrooms were. None of those things. I was a tour guide. So I had to learn on the job. Which was really quite hilarious at King's because, I mean, as you know, it's a smaller campus, so it's easy to get around, but that was interesting. They also gave me a first summer internship opportunity at the registrar's office, and that really did a number of different things for my personality development, I'd say, not just career development. It helped me understand the Canadian work culture, just the interpersonal skills, just developing more confidence in terms of dealing with people, in terms of interaction, and just picking up on those subtle but very important cultural differences. I did that for a number of years, and I was happy to participate with the King's College community in more than one way. I participated in different International Week opportunities similar to this, in mentorship opportunities wherever available. The faculty and staff there were incredibly supportive, and I guess I was also fortunate somewhat at that time. I don't know how, but that particular year, I was the only student from India. Which is a big surprise, because you know how many people there are in India? Mm-hmm. I was the only one at King's, and now there are apparently 700-800 or so. And people wanted to know where I was from and exchange cultural information and things of that nature. So I developed a lot of good friends there. I built a lot of connections, relationships, and so on. And it's that relationship-building skill that's really quite interesting, because that's how I've come to where I am now. In the current role that I have at LEDC, I'm responsible for bringing new investments to London. Well, most of the work that goes into this part is relationship building. I'm tasked to go overseas to develop relationships with key investors to convince them about opportunities in Canada, Ontario, and London. Essentially, it's the same role that I used to do as a tour guide at King's College. So, in essence, I had to learn about all of the value offerings in London, Ontario, Canada to be able to sell new investors on opportunities here. And it's that relationship building skill that comes in handy all the time. And, it's really interesting how we are here to talk about our experiences in moving in Canada, because I feel that's how I'm able to provide service to my clients, because I know what the barriers would be and I'm able to remove them before they face those challenges and barriers, and clients really appreciate that. What are some of the highlights of the experience? I think I mentioned Western King's and the education components. I stayed on campus a couple of years, and from here I went to Waterloo to do my grad studies there, and I really found that the experiences at King's and Western really helped in Waterloo as well. So much so that upon graduation from Waterloo, I had a couple of options to move to Ottawa, Toronto, or London, and I chose to come back to London. The lifestyle in London was much better from a cost of living standpoint, the quality of life. I tried ice skating myself, and after nearly breaking open my skull a couple of times, I decided that's not really the sport for me, so I chose golf. A little less risky from that standpoint. But I got into golf. I started getting engaged in some of these social activities, and you know, things kept falling in place. I guess similar to your advice, and I think you nailed it really well. I would one advice that I keep offering to newcomers is be open for change. I think the folks who express struggle to me are the ones who have been very closed, knit, and not being receptive to change, to interaction with fellow Canadians. And when I say fellow Canadians, it's not just native people, right? It's folks like us who have also come here from somewhere else. And we have experienced the change based on our attitude for adapting different environments. And I think that's the most important piece of advice anybody could take away, is to be receptive for change, to be open to understanding different climates, different backgrounds, different customs, and really be part of the whole dynamic landscape that it is here. And I think that's the way to flourish. Just trying to think what else I could cover that you haven't already covered really well. It's a big struggle. I think I'll leave it at that, and if there are any questions, I'm happy to address them later. So thanks very much.